Hello students, welcome back to the online class. Today we shall learn a new poem, that is Moon Wind. Let me read the poem for you. There is no wind on the moon at all, yet things get blown about. In utter stillness, your candle shivers out. In utter stillness, a giant mark you booms and flounders past you like a swan at sea. In utter stillness, while you stand in the street, a skull of hens and cabbages knocks you off your feet. In utter stillness, while you stand agog, a tearing, twisting sheet of pond clouds you with fog. A camp of caravans suddenly squawks and takes off. A fairy's wheel bounds along the skyline like a somersaulting giraffe. Roots and foundations, nails and screws, nothing can hold fast. Nothing can resist the moon's deadline blast. Ted Hodges. Meaning of blown about, break in uncontrolled manner. Utter means complete. Stillness, calmness, mark you, a large tent. Booms means loud noise. Skull means a sudden violent wind. Cabbages, of course you know it is a vegetable. Agog, highly excited. Tearing means separating. Twisting, turning. Sheet, surface. Clouds, pull out. Camp means group. Caravans means traveling together. Squawks, noise. A fairy's wheel means a giant revolving wheel. Bounce. Along the sky line, against the sky. Dead still means completely motionless. Blast means blow. Moon Wind by Ted Hodges is full of poet's fantasy. He imagines if there were earth-like life on moon, everything would be blown by the strong wind blowing there. The poet says in the first stanza, the poet says or imagines a burning candle on the moon would shiver in spite of total silence. And again he says, a giant tent would be blown away by the moon wind, which looked like a huge swan flying over the sea. And again he says, if anyone would stand in the street, a skull of hen and cabbages would knock you off your feet. And he imagines that if one would be on moon, the moon wind lift the pond water as a sheet and hit you with it, carrying frog in it. The moonwind lift of a caravan's fairy's wheel would appear to be jumping in the sky like a somersaulting giraffe. So in the last part he says, the poet again imagines that the moonwind is so strong that it could rip apart anything held by roots, nails and screws. He says, It is dead as it is nor blowing or moving. It is silent. And again he says, the moon wind is so strong that it could rip apart anything held by roots, nails and screws. The poet tells us about the wind that blows on the moon. He mentions many strange things we can see in the poem that are happening on the moon. He says that there isn't any wind on the moon, but still things get blown away. There is no wind, then also the candles shivers out. So what he says again, he tries to tell us that many things happening there, and at last he concludes by saying that nothing can resist the moon's dead still blast. It is dead as it is nor blowing or moving. It is silent. Thus we can say that the whole poem is written in imagination, that this may happen in future. That's all today, dear children. Your homework is read the poem carefully, learn the word power, and also learn the 8-line poem. Thank you.